Hey everyone, welcome back to another Counterside video. So in today's video, we are going to be reviewing Kang So-young. And also try to recommend a build for her. But before that, if you want an updated Counterside videos, please hit the subscribe button down below. Okay, so what we have here is Kang So-young. So she is also with Police Watch 4, and she is actually an SSR as well. And take note, guys, she is a soldier. She is not a counter. So more or less for her, she is a ranger. She is ground type, but she actually has all around attack. Okay, so right now I would highly suggest that you guys not take note, not pull for her banner. Because later I will be discussing ways on how to get her for free if you don't know how to yet. Okay, so let's move on to her profile. So Kang So-yoon is an officer of SWAT 4. Again, is a supportive range attacker who rehabilitates criminals by crashing into them with a police car. So very good tactic for her. So I hope that criminal is still alive after her crashing a police car to that criminal. So stat wise here she is. So combat power is at 10,323, HP is at, sorry, before that, before I proceed, these are the stats for her max stats. So again, HP is at 26,930, which is actually below average. Attack is at 2,802, which is low, but actually is around below, it's near below average, so kind of decent as well. Defense is low, of course. Crit hit is at below average, hit is at below average, and evasion, which is low but also near below average. So more or less she is kind of squishy. She is actually, by the way, good for 2 deployment cost. So you could actually spam her supporting her troops, and actually you can spam her and dropping her above a sniper, so she can be deployed anywhere in the battlefield. So as you can see for her skills, she doesn't have much in terms of active skill. She has 1 basic skill and 3 passive skills. Again, she is a soldier. So for her basic skill, fires a pistol at a target, so 1-1-1 target. So basic attack damage is maximum going to be a plus 20% up to level 5. Next is her passive skill, where's the location. So valid hits is 2. So this is actually a funny skill I've ever seen. Driving a police car, she can be deployed anywhere on the battlefield, as I've said. She can be dropped on snipers. She can be dropped on threats behind the front line of your enemies. Knocks enemies backward with an AoE damage when deployed, and summons a shield man at the same level on the spot where her car exploded. I think the shield man is a single stronghold, so this is actually an additional protection in terms of shielding or in terms of defense. Level 2 to level 4 for the skill is in attack, so plus 3, plus 3, and plus 6, a total of plus 12. And her level 5, her passive skill is explosion damage plus 50%. Summon stronghold instead of shieldman. Sorry, the first part was shieldman. Once you upgrade her to level 5, it's already a stronghold. So again, very good skill, very good in terms of surprise attacks for the snipers at the back. And she is actually a very good support for soldiers, as you can see in her second passive skill. Special Service Commander, so uses her experience of fighting CO as a non-counter commander, decreasing surrounding soldiers' damage taken by 15% and increasing their attack by 15%. So she is going to be the queen of all your soldiers. So more or less, you have to surround her with a lot of soldiers, with the exception of a lot of soldiers. And also you have to bring single, you know, character soldiers with you at the same time. I think she can be mixed with, I think, 1 or 2 counters, but more or less her team comp is going to be mostly soldiers. Okay, for this passive skill, which is Special Service Commander, Level 2, 3, and 4 is a addition on HP, which she actually needs for survivability. So a total of 20%, 5, 5, and 10. And her level 5 buff effect changes to soldier damage taken minus 20 and attack plus 20. So from 15% minus 15 to minus 20 damage and plus 15 attack to plus 20 damage. So again, very good support unit or very good support soldier for your soldier teams. Again, soldier teams are somehow a meta in other servers. More or less they're being used, and they're used basically just to spam units, low cost units. Again, Kang Soyun is actually two. Most of the soldiers are two as well. So spamming units, multiple units, although they die quickly, you could quickly spam them as well. And her last passive skill is Special Operations Strategy. Uses a strategy developed to counter special crimes. Inflicts 5% or more damage on counters. Again, this is going to be a big headache for counters. If you want to build her and a meta team for her, it is actually very possible. So again, she inflicts damage more to counter. So again, there's a damage buff, level 2, 3, and 4. It's a total of plus 10%. So again, 5% could be up to 15%. And level 5 is damage to counter, again, plus 5. So that's a total of plus 15. Yes, so a total of plus 20. And damage to sniper is plus 30%. So again, she really hates snipers. So drop a car on those snipers, will you? And out goes a stronghold. So again, she is very viable for a soldier team together with Eddie Fisher. I'll just go to the collection and see and point to you guys what soldier units are viable for her. So here we are. Where is Eddie? Eddie is actually viable for her. I still don't have Eddie. I'm still fishing for him. No pun intended. So Eddie Fisher is actually good in tag teaming with her. He as well is good in terms with soldiers. So decreases surrounding counter damage taken by 10%. So again, very good as well to pair up with Kang Soyun. I won't go into details of Eddie. I'll have a review probably in the future for him when I try to build my own soldier team. Also good in developing. Let's filter out soldiers. Can I filter out soldiers? Mech soldier, yes. Okay, so for soldiers, the ones that is good with her is going to be Stronghold. You also have here Peacekeeper. Where's Peacekeeper? Here, 49, you have Peacekeeper. And you also have Terminator, which is, I think, this one. So again, there is right now we have limited soldiers. I think a couple are coming soon in terms of Southeast Asian server. But again, soldiers are very viable in the meta, and they are a very good counter to counters. Okay, so in terms of gear for Kang Soyun, gear options would be, again, an additional HP for survivability and also additional evasion. So ideally a pairing of this. So for her set option, I would highly suggest either anti-sniper or anti-striker, because she is a ranger and she is vulnerable to strikers and also to snipers. So, and also when she drops that big car on a sniper, she doesn't get killed. So anti-sniper is actually good as well. So more or less that is for her gear options. Probably also you could add for the third line for your gear options is anti-ground damage resistance. That is also good. And always the damage resistance of any kind will be actually appreciated very much if you have them available. So that is it for her gear. So again, she needs to have damage resistance, HP and evasion bumped up through her gear. Okay, so we're here now at practice mode, and let's see her skills. Let's see how she drops a car. This is actually very funny because again, she drops a car and out a stronghold comes out. Again, very good support, especially if you have units at the back of her. She doesn't have that much animations because again, she has three passive skills, which is purely mostly for support. Again, she is of 2 deployment cost, and you can really spam her all over the battlefield as soon as she dies. So again, she's a very good support. You can spam soldiers around, you can actually spam her. So more or less, her animations are very, very simple. So let's check. Let's just have a air unit and see how she reacts. So again, air units, she is a all-around damage dealer, damaging air and ground units. Okay, so before we end this video, so let me teach you where to farm her, just in case you don't know where. You have to go to side story for operations, and you have to go to SWAT 4, and it's actually 3-4. You could actually farm her here. That is why I would not recommend you pulling for her banner, because you can farm her here. So the main reward would be actually pieces of information about Kang Soo-yun. So these are your shards, but you actually have a chance to recruit her outright. So again, this is a good way to farm for her. So just have to grind this one and probably get more copies. So again, what I would suggest is you don't pull for her banner. Okay, again, so you see her banner, don't pull. I would repeat this, you would only be wasting your recruitment or your employment contract here. So more or less, my final thoughts for her would be, if you intend to build a soldier team to counter the counters, then she would be a key piece in that team. She is valuable together with Eddie Fisher, together with your soldiers. I assume that there are a lot of soldiers coming our way. So more or less, I think the soldier meta will be slowly be building up as soon as we get more soldiers. But now, try to farm for her and be ready just in case you intend to construct a soldier team. So anyway, guys, I would like to thank you for those who have stayed up to the end of this video. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel, and also don't forget to click that bell icon so that you'll be notified anytime I have uploaded a video. Also, guys, please don't forget to leave a like if you feel that this video has been informative, and also put comments down below, suggestions on this video, on, let's say you have suggestions on other builds for Kang Soo-yun, please put them down in the comment section below. Okay, guys, take care, stay safe. This is the Warden, and I'm out of here.